I'm Claire Bueno as Australian gem Sapphires receives its UK premiere.
Life wasn't always so glamorous for us. Today I started... But things changed when we met Dave Lovelace.
Okay, that wasn't terrible. Do you sing anything other than that country and western shite?
What do you think we should sing?
Soul. Not ding ding ding, just boom, 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 boom.
He's a bit silly in the head, I reckon, eh?
Hello, UK.
Hello, UK.
And what a great film to be a part of.
Oh my gosh, yes. It's just such an exciting film, and to be acting in and to now promote, it's especially here in London, it's just so special.
Yeah, it certainly is. Where, you know, we went in doing this film very proud and committed, and we definitely knew from the beginning that it was going to be, I guess, special, you know, for our home, for our, you know, Australia, and knowing that, you know, it was based on true events and tells part of Australia's history. So, you know, to be able to share it with the rest of the world, it's a massive honour and pleasure, you know, and telling someone else's story as well.
Yeah, and to inspire young girls as well, if they can see that these four women have gone through all these hardships to find happiness and to achieve their dreams, then I hope they come out of the film going, man, I can do with anything with my life. Yeah.
It is really inspirational, and the story, as we said, is true. But they were relatives, weren't they? So how did you all gel together? Because you're not related as actors. How did you all gel together to get that, bring that truth really to a family unit?
I think it was pretty natural. I mean, myself, Miranda and Shari, we come from the same country town, Darwin, and I guess it was just our upbringing and our. A natural connection that we had, and we just really,
we wanted the film to do well, and we all believed in the story, didn't we, Jess? And I just think that we couldn't really have any sort of ego in the way, because it'd be at the cost of the story, and we just loved it too much.
The other thing just to ask you as well is the costumes and the hair. That must have been incredible for you as actresses, wasn't it?
It was. I mean, we had a great team. We had a really amazing costume team that just put everything together and you know, did it by hand. And we just had the pleasure of, you know, wearing their amazing outfits and putting the beehives and, you know, teasing the hair and singing a wonderful music, especially. I mean, it's a great honour to be, you know, singing Sugar Pie Honey Bunch, you know that I love you, Who's Loving You, you know, by the Jackson 5. I mean, yeah, so it's such a pleasure to be able to, you know, recreate those songs in our way.
Soul music is about loss. Now, what it is that you're searching for, that's up to you. I'm just here to get you there. One, two, three. Okay, wrong hands, girls.
Put the candles on the table.
Wrong hands.
Back it up, back it up.
How do you feel about not singing lead?
How do you feel about getting knocked out by a woman?
Such an exciting script to be a part of, isn't it?
Oh, it is. This is massive for us. You know, we made this film just over a year ago. The fact that it's had this journey in a short amount of time and going to Cannes, Toronto, and now we're here in London. Like, this is amazing.
I think what's incredibly inspirational as well is that it's based on a true story, isn't it?
Yeah. The writer, the co-writer Tony Briggs, it's his mother and his auntie's story. And these sassy, fierce, independent, beautiful black women just who went for it, you know, 200% in the 60s in an extremely sort of racist period of Australian history. Not a great time for women in general, really. And they just went, bugger that, we're doing what we want. Yeah. So
it is such an inspirational story, isn't it?
Oh, definitely, definitely. I mean, the aunties themselves, you know, they came and saw the film, and it, just to see their face and to give them that acknowledgement, you know, I think it's really wonderful that we can represent our women in this way.
Yeah. And the music, of course, is everything in the film, isn't it? So what was that like performing that?
Oh, look, it was like sort of patting the head and rubbing the belly and dancing all at the same time. Like, yeah. It was a little bit tricky, a lot out of my comfort zone. So, but it was fun. I mean, the music is, it's soul. Yeah. It's Motown.
It's real music.
Yeah.
Compared to, you know, some of the stuff you hear today is a bit, not, and that's why it's so great to hear Jess's voice and Who's Loving You's, numbers like that. There's just, it's soul. There is so much soul.
One, two, three.
Welcome to Saigon. If you can't shake your moneymakers tonight, you're all on the first plane back to Austria tomorrow.
Australia.
You got to know how to pony.
was out of sight.
I wanted to ask you about the crafting of the comedy. You've worked in the States, obviously in the UK, and does it change now in Australia, the way you perform the comedy?
No, not really. I mean, as long as the people that are at the top of the tree have the same kind of sensibilities, it doesn't really matter. And I find that the differences are probably far less than you would imagine in terms of whether it's Graham Linehan or Judd Apatow or Wayne. They find the same things funny. So as long as I can make some of those things happen, then it's a very similar experience.
And the script for you, what enchanted you about it?
I felt like I didn't know the world. It felt very new to me. I felt ignorant about it, which is always tantalizing. And the music is just incredible.
Going through the Sapphires for three headline-busting weeks.
This isn't the place to be encouraging romance. We're here to work.
Speak for yourself, sister.
How conscious were you when you were casting the four leading ladies?
Yep.
How their chemistry would work together to make it such a balance on screen, really?
Yeah, I mean, that was primary for the roles, because they had to be a family that knew each other for like 20, 30 years. So, and it's funny enough that there's two Darwin girls that knew each other through NIDA, which is the Australian acting course, which Judy Davis and Mel Gibson went to. So they were really great. It was Deb Mailman, our lead, was the elderly lady in the group. I'd known for many years. So, and Jess Mauboy is such got a beautiful, I don't know, you can choose people and they might hate each other, then you might get good product, but then you might get people that love each other and shit the film. But we got it right, fortunately. I could be here forever telling you, but we got it right. And it's a guess and it's a fluke, but you could tell from the first hour of day, you know they'd look after each other.
We should dance.
Stand back, Jack. This little duck gonna go quack, quack, quack.
What a precious evening it's been here at the BFI London Film Festival as Sapphires received its UK premiere.
All right, let's go steal some petrol.
You never told me that your uncle was Irish.
We try to hide that.